Under the celebrity spotlight tonight on Remember When, our old favourite, our old mate Darren James.
And, well, old is appropriate because we go back a long way and we're not getting any younger. We're heading in the same direction.
We might be, but it's not age, it's longevity of friendship.
If you feel like a 20-year-old and you still have loyalty towards someone that you worked with all those years ago, and you think back at the times that you had, and it still brings a smile to your face, you can't have done too badly.
Having known and worked with you for 10 years, even more, I'm still 15 years of age between my ears.
That's good. I think that's a positive thing.
Of course.
As long as you don't go backwards to a sort of 10-year-old, that's getting a bit spooky.
And that's been said by management in many a meeting, I have to say, as well.
Darren,
well, when your wife says to you that your son is more mature than you are, I don't know whether that's a good thing or a bad thing. But, life is good. I enjoy every day.
Mate, he was more mature at birth when we visited him at the Mercy Hospital.
That's right.
18 years ago.
Well, no, 24 years ago.
24 years ago.
Yeah, crazy stuff.
When we sat shaking in Amarillo's
hotel. After going on a cruise.
Yeah, all right. Darren, let's just put the spotlight on you. Dad was in radio, very successful on Breakfast at Ballarat and here at 3AW.
Yes, he did Breakfast at 3AW for 8 years. Can you believe that?
Yes.
And growing up, I used to go in with him. Then in those days, the announcers used to do 6-day shifts. And so, people like Mannion would do 6 days and Jim Archer and my dad would do 6 days. And so I would go in, I remember him doing Saturday mornings, and I'd go in with him on a Saturday morning and sit with him when I was, 5 and 6 and just for the fun of it. And I loved it and got to know the panel operators and thought, that's what I want to do for a living. And just stuck at it, and here we are talking all these years later.
Did you get the chance to go on air with him? Did he ever say, oh, this is my son, Darren? Have you got a tape of a squeaky-voiced young man?
No, he never. He used to just, always in the background, which I think was a good thing. And when I decided I wanted to get into the radio industry myself, he said, well, you're not getting any help from me. And which is a good thing as well. He said, if you want to do it on your own ability. And that was a great thing. And you get accused, of course, along the way of, oh, your old man got you the job, and I see your son's got the job in an AW as well. And you get accused of all that sort of stuff, but it's just not true, and that's good.
Well, 30 years ago, even more, our paths crossed on Breakfast with you, myself, and John Blackman, which were wonderful days leading up to the days we worked together in the mid-80s.
Those fantastic times, and one of my fondest memories, because I knew you used to work with Annette.
Yes, Annette Allison, yes.
That's right, and as the newsreader, but I didn't know how funny you were. And when there was one day you were filling in or doing something in there at 3AW, and I was the panel operator, and Noel Ferrier had come along, and I introduced myself to you, and we got on like a house on fire. We started doing gags and laughing, and then Noel turned up. I reckon my memory of it is, anyway, in the studio foyer there, we were there for about 30, 40 minutes doing voices. You were doing impersonations. We had Noel doing gags. He was laughing. We were all crying. And I thought, this is what showbiz is all about. This is, and I'm with the strength. I'm with Noel Ferrier and Bruce Mansfield, aged about 19, doing gags, and we're all laughing. I don't know whether you remember that.
Oh, I'll never forget it. He was one of the most beautiful, funniest men I'd ever met, and we just hit it off, the three of us.
Wasn't he?
Oh.
And then we went on to work with him briefly at 3AK once we'd been given the T1 from Breakfast at 3AW.
Now, what was he doing at AK? Was he doing mornings, or was he a guest?
I think he was a sort of semi-regular guest and used to pop in. I know I've got an 8x10 black and white photo,
yeah, I have
treasure of the three of us.
I've got the same,
me and Noel Ferrier.
The same photo on the set of Ernie Sigley's morning show.
Yes, that's right. That's exactly right. And just and growing up as a kid, and my dad used to work with Mary Hardy, and she used to come around to our place for dinner and stuff, and just the laughs and the. Life is show me if you can get people to love. Look at what Barry Humphries is doing now at Her Majesty's Theatre. I mean, is that just amazing or what? I just can't get my head around Barry Humphries at that age, looking up and at the Dame End, and you think it is a woman doing gags.
Yeah.
That's just the best.
Well, our time together, we took the show, we took breakfast over to Los Angeles, where we met your good mate Joan Rivers, who wanted to put us up in a little cabin in Manhattan.
Yeah, that's right. She loves it. So we got on with Noel, we got on with Joan, and she seriously did. She said, "Hey, you guys, you make me laugh. Seriously, anytime you're in LA, come and stay with me. Come
yes,
on."
She did. She said, "Stay there. You can have separate rooms," and I thought, well, that'd be marvellous. then we went to China, we went to Singapore, we took breakfast up there.
Yes, and London, of course, for the royal wedding.
Oh, yes, Fergie and Prince Andrew's wedding.
And we were with John Michael Howson then, another show business legend who understands how you behave in the industry, and he showed us around London, I remember.
Nobody takes us around better than John Michael Howson. He knows all the tourist spots, he knows the city of London or LA, wherever he is, and he's a great guy, isn't he?
He is one of the best and passionate about life and the business as well, for sure.
Yeah. Well, perhaps a question from you, Simon.
Look, I also seem to recall, Darren, from my youth...
Has Bruce run out of material?
Oh, yes, I know.
No, that last answer was too abrupt.
Now, do I recall that you were once upon a time a member of the Could Have Been Champions as well, back in your youth?
Yeah, that's true. I started, the Could Have Been Champions, I was mates with Ian Cover, who was a journalist on the TV scene. And I met him at a function. He said, "Hi, I'm Ian Cover. I write for the TV scene. Are you the panel operator for Bruce Mansfield and Darren Hinch?" And I said, "Yes, I am." And so we got together and spent the whole night together just sharing stories about the industry and became great friends. He was a member of the Could Have Beens on Triple R, and I went in and did a couple of voices on their show and got to know them. And I said, I came up with this idea. I said, why don't we put in to replace Ray Taylor over Christmas as the Could Have Been Champions? And the boys said, what, commercial radio off the community radio? Sure. So we went to Brian White. Brian White said, yeah, I'm going to give you blokes a go. So we did it for 4 weeks. And it went off. It went really well. He said, okay, I'm going to find a permanent gig for you, guys. And we ended up doing the Could Have Been Champions on for AW at the weekend, for sure, yeah.
And another feather in your bow was being the first love god.
I was the first love god in this town on Melbourne's Mix 101.1, double TFM, the best mix of music and the biggest variety from the 70s, 80s,
strong.
And 90s.
How did that come about? Was that after the Uncle Roy and Darren James show?
Well, remember that Alan Bond, Bruce, sold 3AK.
That's right.
And an Italian bought it, and we couldn't speak Italian, so we were given our marching orders. So I was out of work for about 9 months, and Double TFM called up and said, come and do breakfast, and I was doing it with Jane Holmes, who we all know.
Yes.
And we did it for a couple of years, and they hired an American consultant to try and get the ratings up. And he came over, his name was Tom Watson, and he said, hey, I've listened to the show, breakfast, hey, it's got a few bumps in it. He said, the girl's great, the guy's got to go.
Oh, great.
So they said, we can cut your wage by a third, or we can put you on nights. And I said, I'll do nights, thanks. And I'm like, oh, okay. They said, well, we've got this idea for a show called Love Songs and Dedications. So I was the first love god in Melbourne.
Yes. Fun memories?
Oh, well, you know, one night Gary called up and he said, g'day there, how you going? I said, on Melbourne's Mix 101.1 double TFM, the best mix of music and the biggest variety from the 70s, 80s, and 90s. Lionel Richie up next. Do you have a dedication to make, Gary? He said, yes, my girlfriend, Cheryl. Where did you meet Cheryl, Gary? Oh, I met her at the Tunnel Disco. And just before Mariah Carey on Melbourne's Mix 101.1 double TFM, what would you like to say to Cheryl if she's listening? Cheryl, I just want to say, I'm really sorry for stabbing you, and I hope you get out of hospital soon. So Fred, everybody called up and said, would you like to come into a gardening show? I thought, it might be a lot easier.
Well, that gardening show and buy, swap and sell, the history of those and the success you're having with ratings is outstanding.
Well, it's it's gone well, although they did say, come and do weekends, we'll find a little spot for you on afternoons, or maybe, you know, you don't know what's happening in breakfast, stick around on weekends, and we'll put you in another shift somewhere, hopefully in, you know, 6 months to a year. That was 20 years ago.
Yeah. You're the radio version of Peter Hitchener, really, all those years waiting for Brian Naylor to leave.
That's right. I'm just waiting for Bruce to go.
Lovely talking with you, Darren. Thanks for the night.
Lots of fond memories, Bruce. And I don't know whether... Have you been watching the Olympics and stuff? I was watching Big Dave Sport for me yesterday in front of the television. I watched Collingwood, which was a great win.
Oh, yes.
Even though it was disappointing to... There was no side bottom there. So what we did was tune over to the women's beach volleyball where there was plenty of side bottom.
Yeah. dear. Yeah, how was the Queen and James Bond? That was marvellous.
That was my highlight. For the Queen to do an acting role and say, good afternoon, Mr. Bond, was the highlight of the Olympics for me so far.
Me too.
For me, it was...
You know why? Because I don't care what anyone says, you know, you get your critics, oh, the Queen shouldn't have done it, oh, it was a bit tacky and all that, it was a bit stupid. You know why I liked it? Because it was funny.
Yeah, I agree with you. And they sent the whole thing up, too, the whole opening.
And just have a laugh and enjoy what's funny.
Yeah, I agree.
For me, it was Rowan Atkinson doing the Chariots of Fire. Also,
and you know why you enjoyed it? Because it was funny.
Yeah, yep. Exactly. Not a lot of fun in the world.
Exactly.
All right, Darren, thanks for the weekend and thanks for our friendship.
Thanks, Bruce. Thanks. I'd love to catch up. We'll go to the Tip Top Club and have a couple of crannies and reminisce.
Sad. Okay, Darren. See you.
See you, Bruce.
Bye.
Wear a smile upon your dial. Let Uncle Roy and Darren tickle your fancy for a while. There's Jacob, Stewart and Rayner all on the show today. Pinch's editorial, don't you want to stay? So when you wake up in the morning, you're going to have lots of fun with Uncle Roy and Darren, breakfast of champions. When you wake up in the morning, wear a smile on.